We're going to focus on that one first because it is a scripture of many which is sorely misquoted in terms of trying to make it viable in defining or defending that when we die, we don't go straight to the grave. People use this scripture in its misquoting to say this: to be absent from the body is to be present from the Lord. That's not what it says. And furthermore, they should be reading from 2 Corinthians 5, 6 through 5, 8, or 9 to get a clearer understanding of what this scripture is saying. Because in its entirety, in those three or four verses, it's very clear what it's saying. So with that being said, we're going to first read it from the NIV. Now, I have several different types of Bibles. Another factor, like I said, there's so many factors and avenues to understand when you're studying scripture. Like I always say, I use a version of the 1843 King James. Why? Because after 1881, more history lesson, understand the history of the Bible, understand language, terminology. It's a lot. You spend your lifetime doing this. But after 1881, Bible societies infiltrated Bibles and started changing them, literally, in all the aspects. Look at what we have today. I'm going to read 2 Corinthians 5, 8 from the NIV Bible and from the Clear Word Bible just to show you. Scripture tells us about changing His Word. We're not supposed to do that. Now, is the 1843 version of the King James perfect according to what a man would say? No, but it hasn't been changed. As I was saying, we're going to first read 2 Corinthians 5:8 in the New International Version. And this is one of those modern day version of Bibles to help it, to help individuals understand scripture more easily. We keep trying to modernize these scriptures so that it reads very simply and clear, but what we're doing is we're changing the wording, we're changing the structure of the scriptures, we're changing the meanings, we're eliminating referencing. There's no references in this. I mean there are a couple. Just on this one page alone, there are only three references for a whole page of scripture. In my scripture here, my 1843 King James, for the same page, there's no less than 25 references based on the various scriptures. So how do you get from one page with 25 or 30 references to a newer version Bible that has three references for the total page, which encompasses 40 scripture at least? It takes away from the meaning and the ease of clarity in studying the scripture. But we're going to read 2 Corinthians 5:8, and this is out of the NIV first. And we're going to start with verse 6. It says, "Therefore we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord." That's clear in its writing. Verse 7, "We live by faith, not by sight." That's clear also. Verse 8, "We are confident, I say, and would prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord." And that's clear. Verse 9, "So we make it our goal to please Him, whether we are at home in the body or away from it." So in those four scriptures, I mean, it's very simple and clear in the NIV. But understand, like I said, it takes away from the ability for the rest of the whole Bible to reference scripture upon scripture and get clarity of meaning from tons of other scriptures which may refer back to this exact scripture. So in that context, it's not a good thing, but in the way it is written, it's a very simply understood scripture. It's saying that we, as long as we're in this body, we are away from the Lord. Now, the clear word, same thing. We're going to get to the clear word. We're going to start with verse 6, 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 6. It reads, "That's why we can speak with such confidence, even though we're still living in our mortal bodies and away from the Lord." Verse 7, "Actually, we are not away from the Lord. He's here with us, not by sight, but by faith. That's clear. Verse 8. That's what faith is all about. We long to lay aside our bodies and leave this present world and to be at home with the Lord. And finally, verse 9. But whether we are here or there isn't the point. Our only goal is to please God and show Him how much we love Him by obeying Him. And that's clear. It's slightly different than the NIV, but the sentiment of what they're both saying is exactly the same. It is not saying anything about when we die, we go straight to heaven. This is talking about what we would like. We would like to be away from this body and with the Lord, but in the meantime, we're not. We're here, so we're here to please Him. Now those are fine for the reading, but to understand Scripture through and through, it is a disaster. You don't have the references, as with the King James, and you don't have dates. You have to know where you are in time prophecy to truly be able to follow and understand Scripture. Now we're going to read 2 Corinthians 5:8 in the King James, starting with verse 6. It says, therefore, we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. It's clear to me. It's confusing to some people, but as you study even the King James, because it's primarily based in some of its old English wording and writing, but it becomes very easy to understand once you start studying it. Verse 7 reads, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Very clear. Verse 8, we are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Very clear. Now, verse 9, whether we labor, that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of Him. And that's very clear. Now, to say all three of them are saying the same thing is true, but the point we need to understand is saying that we have a desire, or we are willing to be present from this body and to be present with the Lord. We are willing to be away from this body and present with the Lord. The quoting that people use, they say to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. None of these say that. They say we are willing to be away from this body and to be present with the Lord. So when people quote the scripture and say to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord, they are saying that once we're away from this body, we're present with the Lord. This is where that confusion of when we die, we go straight to heaven to be with the Lord comes from, because of one little word, and is. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Misquoting the scripture. Even the clear word and the NIV say and or willing. It doesn't say we are present with the Lord, as people misquote it. Now, the second thing is in the King James, unlike the other two, it gives us a reference for verse 8. It gives us Philippians 1:23. So let's go to Philippians 1:23 and read it. Philippians 1:23 reads, well, we're going to start with 22. It's always important sometimes to read scripture around a verse because it helps it. But we're going to start with verse 22. It says, but if I live in the flesh, this is the fruit of my labor. Yet what I shall choose, I wot not. Verse 23, for I am in a strait betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. Verse 24, nevertheless, to abide in the flesh is more needful for you. So, verse 23, Philippians 1:23, solidifies the meaning or understanding of 2 Corinthians 5:8. It says that, for I am in a strait betwixt two. I'm in a quadrant here. I'm in a position I'd rather not be in. I have a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. But because we're here in the flesh, that's not possible right now. So In the meantime, we have to live in this body with that desire. It says nothing about to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. People need to stop misquoting scripture. And I get that, because people are raised hearing that from other individuals. And as you hear something more and more, it becomes the truth. But study it on your own. When you hear people quoting scripture all the time, read it, study it, get the references from it to the other, through the other scriptures, so that you can understand it. Now, we have two more scriptures that we're going to focus on, which people desire to use to say that when we die, we go straight to heaven or hell. Now, hopefully for those whom it will help, this notion and thought has been cleared up, because some of you respond and say, well, this scripture, referring to this one, is confusing. I understand what you said with life and death and what happens, and that makes a lot of sense. But what about this scripture? Because it confuses me. So for at least that one individual, I hope this helps you with that understanding and gives you clarity on really the separation between what I was teaching and what this scripture means. So with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. Study the word, people. It's clear and simple. This is Tube 87. I'm out.